Today, we're having a garage sale. Look at all this great stuff I have to offer. Well, I don't have a cash register. How am I going to know how much change to give customers when they give me more money than what their items cost? Stick around and I'll teach you how. Often at garage sales, customers will give you the correct change when they purchase items because the cost is kind of low. But if they load up on lots and lots of your wonderful merchandise, sometimes it gets a little tricky to figure out how much change you owe them. When the items add up to, say, $4.50 and the customer gives me a $20 bill, what am I going to do then? I don't have a digital readout on a cash register to help me figure that out. Old-fashioned cash registers would act as adding machines and add up prices for the cashier. But there was no way to put in how much money that customer gave you and figure out how much change was owed to them. So there was this method that was called counting back change that people used to use. It's still very helpful today when you're running a garage sale or just to figure out how much change the cashier should be giving you. Basically, what you do is take the cost of the item. Let's say it's $3.75. The customer gives you a $20 bill. You are having a hard time subtracting $3.75 from $20 in your head, but you don't have to subtract at all when you count back change. Here's a sample of some merchandise that a customer may buy from me at my sale. There's a hat for 75 cents, a little dish for another 75 cents, so that's $1.50. A cute little snowman dish for $1, so that brings the total to $2.50. A nice little pitcher for $2, $3.50, $4.50, and an Oreo mug for 10 cents. So their total is $4.60. Bam, your items come to $4.60.
I only have this 20. Do you have change?
I do. Okay, 20. $4.60. Okay, well, here's a dime that makes it $4.70, $4.75, $5, and another 5 makes it 10, and 10 makes it 20. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Okay, notice what I did. The first amount I said was the $4.60 that she owed me. And then I kept adding on money till I got up to the $20 that she had given me. So $4.60 plus 40 cents made it $5. Another $5 bill made it 10. Another $10 bill made it the 20 that she gave me. Let's try it again. Okay, this customer has brought up this merchandise to buy. A little snowsuit for $2. A set of Christmas placemats for $3, so that's $5, and 3 of these little stuffed toys, which I'm selling for 25 cents each. So their total comes to 2 plus 3 is 5, plus 75 cents is $5.75. Pam, your amount comes to $4.75.
Oh man, I wish I had the right change. All I have is this 10.
It's okay, I can make change. All right. $10. Your amount is $4.75. So I'll give you a quarter that makes it $5, and $5 makes it the 10 you gave me. Thanks so much for shopping at my garage sale.
You're welcome.
I hope that this has been a helpful little tutorial for you on how to count back change, beginning with the amount the customer owes you and then adding on money till you get up to the denomination or the total amount of money that was given to you by the customer.
If you like this video, make sure you leave a thumbs up, comment down below, and subscribe, and make sure you tell your friends.
Because we want you to never stop learning!